Selling the house with the intention to have you kicked out. Wow, that is... that is some garbage right there. Okay, so this is... seriously? You fucking evil shit of a door? Oh my god. It's a secret, but we've been to both sides of it. I do not understand. Okay, but seriously though, y'all need to like come over to this wall so that I can dragon sprint the shit out of you. Today, please. I am in a hurry. I have things to be doing, like, oh god. Like grinding archaeology and RuneScape. I also discovered I discovered earlier that I cannot be recording video and brewing coffee and an espresso all at the same time on the fuse that is hooked up to my room. It blows the fuse. First world problems. Okay, so I think there are a shitload of people in this corner. What's up, dudes? Eat shit. Coffee in another room, but my coffee maker is in this room. You're just asking the impossible of me. Also, that would require far more movement than I am willing to put in. Yeah, that is like my go-to stream drink. Before every stream, I make a 32-ounce thing of coffee and a double shot, and I pour a double shot of espresso into it. And that is my streamer fuel. It's also why I'm probably going to die by the time I'm 35, but we don't talk about that part. Oh, everybody's sad because haste wore off. I'm sad too. Using the toaster and the kettle shut down the entire kitchen. Yep. Yep, the house I grew up in, like, we couldn't run the vacuum in any of the rooms of the house if, like, basically anything was running or it would blow the fuse. Because reasons... I don't even know. Shared life. You fucking shits. Throwing death magic at me while I'm topping everybody's hit points up. Is there a nice mass of them over here? And not as big as I would like. Come on, get grouped up. Just like that. Hi. This is Rove. He casts Dragon Breath. Yeah, kinda like that. And then the rest of us just mow you down. Oh, wow, he has enough spell points. He can cast Dragon's Breath 3 times. I will take it. I don't need him to cast Dragon's Breath 3 times, but he can. Oh, buddy, you are in trouble. Coffee maker on the toilet table, saves time. Pooping while making coffee, plus it smells good. Oh my god. That is hilarious. I mean, we never had a table for magazines next to our toilets. We had like a little basket with magazines in it. That's about the extent of it. These guys are just freaking endless! Mother of God! They just do not stop. This reminds me of playing like Vermintide, where you finish a mission and you realize you've killed like 3,000 living creatures. And I mean, sure, they're just rat men, but damn. Mixer on, the coffee machine, the microwave, and the oven at the same time. Holy shit. Must be nice living in your fucking Germanic utopia with functioning power in your houses. Self-flexing on everybody here. Just... This actually hurts us. Okay, it does. All right, yes, pain. Owie, owie, owie. Son of a bitch, Rove, nobody said you could sleep on the job. Suddenly lava.
Can we assist you?
Oh god, Wizardry 8. I don't know what it would require for me to play that game. Honestly, for sheer time commitment, I think I am more likely to play Wizardry 4 than Wizardry 8. Purely because if I were going to play Wizardry 8, I would want to import a character, like a party that I played through Wizardry 6 and Wizardry 7. And no. Alright, we've aggroed like everything over there. Now we just need to wait for it to get into position so that I can kill it. Alright, if I just sit here... Oh, are you all gonna just get stuck on the ledges again like you did last time so that I can just indiscriminately fireball you? Oh, you are? How wonderful! Here we go. I'll just have everybody shoot arrows while I drink delicious, delicious caffeine. Okay, so... Oh, those are... Above? Ah! Falling damage. Dudes, actually, that is a lot of dudes. Let's see. I'll be with you shits in just a moment. Just gotta kill this damn wizard. Alright, who else wants some? Oh, there's groups up top, too. I like seeing that. Jesus! Dragon's Breath is just nuts. Admittedly, these are like weaker enemies, so it makes sense that it just mows them down. But it's satisfying as hell. I'm not even gonna lie. That shared life plus power cure combo is really good. I see you guys over there. I think I don't. Yeah, now that I've actually dumped some levels into Dark Magic Mastery for Rogue, he is doing much better with it. I think the last time when I first used it, I think he was only like level 4 or 6 in Dark Magic. And those extra levels have made a huge difference. At least against lesser enemies. I wouldn't use it over, say, Fireball against tougher stuff, but against things like this, not totally acceptable. All right. Dark death magic, the best kind.
Can we assist you?
Blessed coffee.
Be with
Ken. No, get Rove his mana too. Rove, rehaste the party so that it doesn't wear off and everybody gets sad. Alright, that's the coffee gone. 32 ounces in an hour and 20 minutes. Nice. Okay, so we have an altar. I can't do anything with it. I'm sure that that thing's gonna kill me if I try to fuss with it. If I had to guess. Maybe. Maybe not. I don't know. I do want to poke around a little bit, because it looks like we've got some access to areas here, and then Lord knows what's up there. Toilet in the stairway. Ouch. Nobody wants to sit on a cold toilet seat. That is always, like, terrible. And by cold, I mean like a freezing cold. Like, room temperature is one thing, but if it's like 2 degrees outside, woof, wakes you up.
No problem.
Get a fuzzy toilet seat. Oh my lord. Alright, can't do any of these. Well, that was less than helpful, I suppose. Seriously, game. No. Okay, I was gonna say, I'm surprised we haven't really picked up any loot off of these guys, but we have. Wow, one hit point. Mind blown. Oh my god, a fuzzy toilet seat and a shag rug near the toilet. That's... just thinking about that skeeves me out. So the only thing we have available to us now is that door that I'm almost positive is going to kill people if I try to open it. Wait a minute. No, just misaligned wall textures or something? Sure. A pee rug. You are not worthy of bah. Yeah, I saw that one coming. I suppose Rove is. Nope. All right. Good talk. Old Shagrig on the Temple of the Frog module for the first AD&D. Oh man! Wow. That is a hell of a pull there, Stormcrow. I dig it. I actually used to do that with my third edition groups back in the day, Celt. I used to use Dungeon Magazine. Just, you know, acquire copies of the old Dungeon Magazines and look through them and, like, man, those things are just full of inspiration for adventures. Thank you. the long tunnel. That's a trap. Diplomacy is never the answer, Sel. Come on now. This is D&D. You're nothing but murder hobos. Chest is locked. Oh, hey.
Got it.
Just a bunch of fucking gongs. Decidedly less than ideal. Question is, now that I've come through here, can I get to other places? No. What does that say? It says something that's like almost readable. I'm sure it's probably gibberish, but dang it. Alright, what did we just get? Reanimate. I think that's dark magic.
Okay. Fixed.
Allows you to raise a lifeless creature from the dead. The spell does not make them grateful or peaceful, but you can always kill them again if you want. I don't understand the purpose of this spell. Because I don't think you gain XP for killing reanimated enemies. So it's just like, what? Really? Really? That's my ranged attack. It hurts more. Something to do with this altar. It's blue and highlighted on the map. I wonder if we have to be like wearing that cloak. Wait, what did that say? Ba ba. Ba head 4. 3. 1. 2. 1. I have no idea what that did, but they're all ready. Bah. I gotta play Stonekeep again. I was actually thinking about let's playing it after I'm done with Anvil of Dawn, but I don't know if I wanna go from one jank dungeon crawler right into another one. If you wanna might and magic, the first thing you can do is ignore 9 and pretend it doesn't exist. There are two trilogies that are really worth playing. 3 through 5 and 6 through 8. Personally, I like 3 through 5 better than 6 through 8 because they're like old school grid-based crawlers. And 4 and 5 combine into one game that is really, really good. 3 is kind of like, if you're gonna play the older trilogy, start with 3. Don't play 4 and 5 first, because having played them first, you will not want to play 3, because they're just 3 but better. If you want more seamless gameplay, you'll want to look at 6, 7, and 8. 6 is probably the fan favorite of this trilogy. I think 7 is the best of them. I'm not a fan of 8 because it doesn't let you create your party members, but they're all pretty good games in their own right. But yeah, basically what Celt says, don't touch 1 or 9. 1 is like too old school, and 9 is just a broken pile of shit. all of the other games have at least some redeeming factors to them. I'm gonna see if this will get us through here. Ah, see, I'm a genius. Go forth and spread the word. Evil God XP? Why, yes. Everybody's ready to level. We're monstrous. I'm gonna have to donate at the temple next time we're in town. That's just like 800 gold pieces of donation and we'll be fine. I'm not particularly worried about it. Let's see. This place is like, I have to say, been really obnoxious based on how the doors work. Like sometimes they let you in, but they don't. You have to go through in like a certain order. Why would I play the merge mod? The only thing that entices me about the merge mod is having a 5-character party. That is literally the only thing that entices me about that. And, yeah, I don't think that's gonna be enough to get me to go play it. So, here we are. Yeah, exactly. Like, that's the thing, is there are other ways to get it, so why would I go through the hassle of dealing with, like, all the bugs and stuff in the merge mod? It's just, it's not worth it to me. Holy shit, our, like, hour of power and stuff have worn off. We're fighting without buffs. Ew. I think Day of Protection was still running because it actually lasts, like, 24-hour in-game days, but... Was this Bahead 2? Oh, is that telling me, like, the order that I'm supposed to activate them in or something? Nope. Or maybe did the Baheads change, like, what doors open and stuff? I don't know. Can't do anything with the fire.
Aha!
Day.
Aha!
Alright, just a bunch of crap. Neat! For 6 through 8, you'll probably want to use the Grayface patch. That's what I'm using here. It gives you stuff like Mouse Look, which I think makes the games a lot more playable, but some people do not care for them. For the older games, you're good. Just play them as is. I don't think there are any patches to them. I mean, you'll have, fuck, what's it called? Swords of Xeen, which is like a fan-made version of Might and Magic 5, 4 and 5, but it is not particularly good. I would not recommend playing it. But some people, I'm sure, out there like it. But yeah, play with the Grayface patch. It's kind of a bitch to set up because it adds a lot of options you can tweak and explains, like, next to none of them. But it gives you, like, Mouse Look. You can make it so that music in dungeons loops, because normally it'll only play the track once, and then you're stuck in just silence for the rest of the time. But yeah. Grayface, good. Use Grayface. Dungeon, I do not know what you want from me. I have 2 more rooms. Actually, no, I take that back. We have rooms down here that we can't get into. Or we haven't been able to get into. We'll see if we can go get them now. Oh. Check out Spelljammer. Oh, Lord. That, yeah, and after Spelljammer, just play Descent to Undermountain. If you're gonna go play some of the worst games ever made, you might as well hit the big 2. If you want a quirky one, check out, it's called Blood and Magic. It's an RTS. Like a I wouldn't necessarily say it's D&D, but it's licensed. It's a licensed D&D RTS. It's not bad. It's not amazing. I remember really liking it when I was a kid, and I actually have a box copy of it that I'll probably show off one of these days. I think I've actually shown it off before. But that's pretty fun. Dungeons & Dragons Stronghold is a good time. I'm sure there's more out there too. If you want to go back like really old school, you've got like the Gold Box games. Just ignore Hillsfar because that game's a steaming pile. Yeah, Spelljammer and Descent to Undermountain. I think Scinitar actually did a full playthrough of Descent to Undermountain somehow. Okay. Ooh, severed head. A flower sack. A potion. A potion. Nothing. A potion. Food. Neat. Yeah, drove him nuts. Oh, it's just freaking priests. Okay, there's more than just priests in here. Okay. Note to self, don't just rush in blindly all the time. Only most of the time. Just let them figure out what corners they want to hide in before I rush into the room and hit them with dragon fire. Works for me. Okay, I'm gonna hit this corner first. So good. Now it's gonna be you guys' turn in just a second. And then all that's gonna be left are like the warlocks or whatever they are. Feels good, man. Scinitar knows that people like watching other people play really bad video games, so he plays really bad video games. Like, that's the thing, is you can't necessarily, if you're doing streaming like full-time, like he basically is, you can't necessarily always play what you want to play. You have to play what people want to watch. Like, my viewership on this, for example, has been better than probably almost anything I have ever streamed before, because like this is such a popular game amongst like old RPG fans. And then like if I were to go play something like, I don't know. Aha. Jesus, I really don't know. Under Rail, for example, it probably wouldn't get as good of a viewing. It's the nature of the beast. These things look like the fucking monkey people from Wizardry 8. Mooks, I think they're called. Exactly, Stormcrow, exactly. Yeah, Divinity. Ugh, that fucking game. Yeah, I feel bad for him, although admittedly the game that he was going to play, Pools of Radiance, Ruins of Mithranor, that is a really bad game. Like, really, really bad. Sure. Oh, these are, okay. Each of these is one container. I thought we had four.
I don't know.
Okay, we have to go back to town and sell shit again. Go ahead. Not enough spell points for a Lloyd's Beacon. Like hell, I'm gonna sleep. I am hyped for the new version of Master of Magic as well, yeah. Tentatively could be really cool.
Can we assist you?
I need to not be raging assholes anymore, please. There, now we're respectable again. The system works. Let's go harass shopkeepers really quick. After we sleep, because it's too late right now.
Enjoy your stay.
Looking for a weapon?
Oh, just buy it all. It's crap anyways.
I don't know.
Come again.
Don't touch the merchandise. Come back soon. Don't touch the merchandise. Come back soon.
200k gold. System works.
Come again.
Good old merchant.
Have a look around.
My problem with the combat in Divinity is that it feels like you're playing with, like, the world's worst dungeon master. Because the AI goes out of its way to fucking kill you. Like, to the point... The thing that got me is that, like, it goes out of its way to kill you in ways that, like, break my immersion to such a point that the game pisses me off. That's why I stopped playing it. Is, like, I had my front row of dudes set up, engaged with their front row of dudes, and one of their guys is like, oh, I can path to Squishy Mage in the back, and he just, like, runs all the way around my entire party to fight Squishy Mage at the back, and it's like, wow, that's... All right. And that's when I stopped playing. That game is just not for me. I am hyped for Wrath of the Righteous, though. Very hyped for Wrath of the Righteous. I honestly don't know about that, Peaches. I don't know how much viewership was affected by me swapping streaming between super early on Sundays to Friday evenings and Sunday mornings or Saturday mornings. I don't know. If I really wanted to build, like, a channel viewer base, I would do, like, Monday, Wednesday, Friday or something. But with my work, there is literally no way for me to do that. I just do not even remotely have the time, sadly. I would like to stream more than I do. Admittedly, I wouldn't be opposed to streaming like 2 or 3 times a week, but too busy working. Yeah, I'm not going to be playing Baldur's Gate 3. Like, I full stop, I know. Although, admittedly, I think a lot of the things that made me hate Divinity Original Sin probably wouldn't be present in Baldur's Gate 3, because that's not how Dungeons & Dragons works. Like, all the enemies having ranged attacks, and all the enemies having, like, movement skills and shit. So you could probably form a more effective front line that way, but... Yeah, the story is definitely dry in Original Sin. But, like, the biggest thing that killed me was just, like, just the way the AI behaved. It felt shitty. Like, it did not feel good. Like, if I had known that that's how it was gonna be going in, I would have, like, built characters differently and stuff. But I didn't, and I didn't. It, like, wasn't a problem until later-ish enough into the game that I was, like, 20 hours deep by that point, and it's just like, ugh. Alright, so I have no idea. We have this High Cleric's Key. I have no fucking idea where we are supposed to go in here. Like, there are a couple rooms down here we can't get into, but I just tried them and we just can't get into them. Put your bow into fire, get flaming arrows. Ugh, that fucking disappoints the shit out of me! Like, I mean, it's cool, but, like, I want to play Baldur's Gate. I don't want to play Divinity Original Sin with fucking Dungeons & Dragons names slapped on top of it, which looks like what they're making. That disappoints me. Yeah, see, Natalie, like, that just, to me, that's like, well, if you're gonna play this game, if you wanna have fun, you need to go online and read build guides, and, like, that, to me, is a bad game. I mean, like, yeah, you can turn the difficulty down, but the problems that I have with it are, they're not based on difficulty, they're based on just how the AI behaves. And I don't think cranking the difficulty down will change that, because the AI, to me, believes in a way that is counter to what makes logical sense to me, and that's why it drives me nuts. They're just, they're not games for me. That's fine. I know people really like them. And there's a lot about them to like. It's just, I just don't have the patience for that shit. Makes you think of XCOM. I don't know if XCOM is necessarily what I would compare it to. Because, like, XCOM, in part, you kind of go in expecting that, whereas Divinity Original Sin, like, I don't know, you're just like, it's an RPG. Like, there's a trait you can get on your characters, in, at least in Original Sin 2, called Glass Cannon. It makes you, like, super, super squishy, and I picked that for Rove, because of course I did. But the problem is that if you have a character with that, literally all of the enemies will always focus fire them down every combat. And it's like, well, what's the point of having any characters that are built to tank if they're just gonna focus fire your characters down, like, when they're, like, squishy? Like, yes, it makes sense tactically to do that. But from a gameplay perspective, it feels like shit. Like, I want to have a front row that, you know, holds the enemies off while the back row rains death on them. And the game is just like, no. And that's what I mean when I say it's like playing with a really shitty DM. It's like you're playing with a party and Dave is playing a fighter and he, like, uses a sword and shield, which is suboptimal because, you know, realistically, an enemy can just walk around Dave and beat the shit out of the rest of the party. But Dungeon Master Frank isn't a raging douche nozzle, so he has the enemies sit and beat on Dave instead, and Dave gets to feel good about it. And it's just like, nope. I ain't got time for this shit. So I dumped, like, what, 30 hours, 35 hours into that thing, and I was just like, nah, I'm done. Exactly. Like, I am here to have fun, not have my balls squeezed by somebody that gets off on being a hard ass. Okay, there's one more room to go into. But I don't know how to open the door. Yeah, see? It's like, I don't know. And, like, I'm glad that there is a game like that for people, because, like, people dig that, and, you know, more power to them. It's just absolutely not my style of gameplay. Okay, y'all need to get into your corners so that I can dragon breath you, please. Wrong corner, dude, bro. A for effort, though. Yeah, like, I would have probably, like, you make a good point that games don't have DMs, like, that makes sense. I would have probably been less bothered by Divinity Original Sin if you could give, like, your tanky people some form of effective taunt skill. The game did have taunts in it, but they lasted for, like, a turn, and, like, it wasn't remotely enough. Because I had tanky party members, and, like, they felt tanky, and it felt good. The problem was that the AI just completely would ignore them and go beat the shit out of Rove because they could kill him in two attacks. And I mean, that's a similar problem to, like, how it would be in tabletop D&D if you were playing with a DM that wanted to kill you, is that, like, yeah, the monsters are just gonna walk around your fighter dude and beat the shit out of the mage because he's in range or whatever. But I don't know. Not mean to come this way. I think it would have probably been alleviated by not all enemies having ranged attacks and not all enemies having movement skills. It really annoyed me when you'd be fighting, like, a deer and it would have, like, ranged attacks where it was, like, throwing rocks and shit at your party. It's like, what? It's just the dumbest shit. Yeah, like, I'm okay with some enemies being dickish things. I mean, you gotta keep the back row, you know, on their toes or whatever. But when it's every single fight, and that's how it was in Original Sin 2, is, like, every fight was just this grueling deathmatch. And even worse, I was playing with mods to increase my party size from 4 to 6. And I played with a rebalance mod that made it so that armor and magic shields weren't as jank as they are in the base game. And, like, I was still getting worked. We could punch above our weight class a little bit, but by and large, it was still, most fights were super, super close. And it's just like, holy hell. I could not imagine playing this without, like, a larger party. It's absolutely a nightmare. And, like, I'm all for challenging games. Like, I got through Pathfinder Kingmaker, everything except basically... Actually, I think everything except the last fight. I'm challenging. There was bitching, yeah, but I got through it. And then Divinity Original Sin was just like, nah, bro, we suck. We are going to suck the fun out of this and make you suffer. And I was just like, no, no, you're not. I quit. It felt good. It's interesting that this wall doesn't appear on the map. But yeah, I don't know. I think that from a mechanic standpoint, playing like Pathfinder Kingmaker or Wrath of the Righteous when it comes out in turn-based mode, I think those games are going to be far, far better from a gameplay standpoint than Divinity Original Sin or Sin 2 was. Yeah, you can't put oil barrels down and light them on fire, but you can actually, you know, have a good time without needing to play some, like, mega cheese ball party or whatever. And then you get Sirocco and just completely trivialize everything because the spell's busted as fuck. The spiral, then each head, talk to Ba or you'll be dead. I wonder... I wonder, since we've done those heads, if we can go and talk to that head of Ba and it'll, like, open or something now. Because we also still have this High Cleric's Key. Paizo was not smart when making their spells. Yeah, some of the stuff is... yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's hard to keep balance in a tabletop system that large. We've talked about it before. But yeah, there's some stuff that is just, like, out and out busted. Yeah, stuff like that is not a fan, where it's just complete. Like, watch the last episode or two of my Dragon Quest IX playthrough, the final boss in that game. It's pure, like, literally pure RNG if you beat him. It's just nuts. You nerf Glitter Dust and so on, but then add your own spells that are utterly insane. Yeah, like, that's a thing. And they leave some spells that are, like, crazy ass powerful and they just don't do anything to him. I don't understand it. I don't understand it. But whatever, I'm not a game designer. It's, for the most part, really never been a problem in my games because my players and I play with the understanding that we're not gonna do, like, cheese things, so, like, it's okay, but it is definitely still a failing of the system. Okay, so can we talk to you now? Will you open? No, you just want me to go forth and spread the word of Ba. Son of a bitch. I don't even know what I'm doing in here. Oh no, we were supposed to find a cure in the Superior Temple east of Castle Creek Spire. Find a cure. I assume that's in the High Cleric's room, but goddamn this place. I don't know. I'm basically at the point now where I really hope that Wrath of the Righteous turns out to be, like, the modding for that game turns out to be really, really good. Because if that's the case, I think it's going to have a really long tail end on it. And... people are gonna go nuts, because I mean they went nuts with the first game with adding like new classes and stuff, so being able to like make your own adventures and shit, oh, freaking great. Now they just need to mod in multiplayer and I'll never have to play tabletop again. Oh, let's see. Have I been in all these rooms in the beginning area? Pretty sure I have. Yep. Yeah. I know we've been over there. This door won't open. Yeah. This door won't open. Okay, so we have three rooms, I think, that we can't get into. Look it up. MM6 Superior Temple of Ba. As much as I enjoy running around through the like same three areas time and time and time again. Let's see. Temple of Ba, Kriegspire. New Kriegspire, will that tell me where I'm supposed to go in here? Because holy shit. Well, it gives me a map, and the map's got numbers on it, so that counts for something, I guess. But the numbers don't really tell me a whole hell of a lot. Because the map marker section is left empty! Thank you, Might and Magic 6 Wiki. I appreciate you. I have to talk to the faces again. Bot 2 ready. 1 here. 3. 4 is a go. No, these guys are all just chilling. I am so confused. You know, it annoys me so much I can't open this door, because it means I have to run all the way around. Every single time. Expert perception, like what the fuck does that even mean? What does that even mean? I do like Might and Magic 6 dungeons. Let's see. S. Wow, they've got the Shadow Guild Hideout. Thanks, Might and Magic.fandom.com. Like most fandom wikis, you're a steaming pile of uselessness. Let's see here. Might and Magic 6, the spoiler. Here we go. Where am I? Creek Spire, Superior Temple of Ba. Alright. Oh, let's see. Using both the quarters to gain access to the terrace, yada yada yada. Notice the large head of Ba. If you've been through the Ba test. Well, oh, okay, so the Ba test was actually the little thing we ran through down here with all the sparky death. Okay. Yeah, that was the XP thing. Yeah. Far East Living Quarters. There will be a Sorcerer's Key. Do we have that? We have the High Cleric's Key, and that's it. Oh, no. Now we have a Chest Key as well. Where's the fucking chime in here? Control F, Chime of Harmony. That's the first temple. Never mind. Okay, clear out the two rooms to the left and right. Let me pull up the map so that I can look at this. Clear out the two rooms. We did that. Take the north door. Round to a four-way intersection. Yeah. Clear out the storehouse. Balcony room. Okay, one of the priests has the High Cleric's Key. Alright, return down the corridor eastward. About halfway down there's a secret door in the north wall leading to a vault of treasure, which we found that was this room here. Take the corridor south. It leads to the druid's office. Search the chest on the table. You discover it's locked, and you will be ambushed by druids. Continue back out. There are passages. And I mentioned the baa heads. In the Far East Living Quarters, there will be a High Sorcerer's Key on one of the wizards that you have to kill. Both the High Sorcerer's Key and the High Priest's Key allow you to open the chest in the room that led into this area. Okay. Fucking druids and their mysteries. Okay, so we haven't found the Sorcerer's Key by the look of things. I don't know how. We may have missed a corpse. Sure that there's nothing in here. I think we got everything that was in here. Fairly certain. Yeah. Okay. I just don't know. I assume that these sorcerers are in one of these rooms down over here. I just don't know how to get into them. Because the game won't let me get into them. Wait. The door opened for high perception is the key. So I think they meant that literally. You need like points in perception to open the doors. Wow. Okay. Sure. That is a thing. I am not gonna dragon breath these guys. Fireball. Yeah, okay. I'll do that. Yeah, that's less than bueno. To its credit, the game told us what we were supposed to do. It's just weird. Okay, staff. There's the key. High Sorcerer's Key. All right. Wow. I do not know how I feel about that. I assume we can open this chest back here. I should feel good. No. I feel annoyed. So annoyed.
Aha.
Plus 13 vigor. Not bad. And a letter from Xenifex. Xenifex, I think, is the king of the devils. Silvertongue, my spies report there's a small group of would-be heroes traveling about the land trying to put an end to our little plan for a new world, and they are reportedly seeking permission to visit the Oracle in Freehaven. We must not permit this to happen. If the Guardian awakens before our plan has matured, it will spell the end for both of us. Deny them permission to visit the Oracle, even if it reveals you to be a traitor. We need the time your delay will buy us. Oh yeah, praise Bah, Xenifex. Alright, well, there we go. I hate this dungeon. This dungeon's the worst dungeon. Ooh. We hates it, Precious. So yeah, will these doors just all open for Chunk? No. Alright, so apparently they take, like, certain ranks, maybe. I'm gonna see if we can open this one other door in the main area, and then we're gonna get out of here. Enraged? I wouldn't go that far. I'm gonna say annoyed. Definitely, definitely annoyed. Definitely, definitely annoyed. Alright. What do we got? Crap. Wizard eye scroll. Just, if there's anything in here, just drink it all. Just drink it all, Chunk! Get drunk on all the barrels of power. There's always Mordor. Ugh. Ugh. Selt, why? Okay, we're done. Everybody out. Everybody out of the pool. Fun time's over. We don't even really have enough shit to sell. This crown, though. It's pretty good, but it's not better than what everybody else has got, I don't think. Get out of my way, peasant, or I'm going to start doing violence on you. Alright. To Iron Fist once more, after a small delay. Oh, you shouldn't have done that. You should not have done that. Come on, get all clumped up for me. We have a survivor. He is smarter than his brethren, we will let him go. Press Y. Why would I do that when I can just kill him instead? It's not like I can't just pay the temples to be like, alright, you may have Armageddoned this map, but you're still good. Implying that I value the lives of the peasant folk. I appreciate you, Bean Curry. I really do. You still have hope and faith that I'm not an evil bastard. Alright, dude, bro. Your dude's fucked. It appears this slicker silver tongue really is a traitor! Whoever would have guessed it? You've done a good thing bringing the letter to me. Take it to the High Council so that we can be rid of this wicked traitor for once and for all. Alright. Actually, but first... we got levels. Possibly multiple.
Well done.
That's right. Bathe us in skill points. Rove, of course, lagging behind. He always was a slow child. The dude's last name is, in fact, Silvertongue. He's good with words. What's up, dipshit? No!
Do not believe you've won. Soon the Iron Fist will lose its grip and I will be your king. And you can be sure I won't forget you.
Ah! He did the poof! Alright, let's go pester the Oracle. Dude.
Where are we?
The game took a twist, you guys! It took a twist, we got panels. Power on status, all systems functional. We turned the lights on. Yo, dog. I hope y'all knew. My magic's kind of sci-fi. He vanished. With great aplomb. Lighting system does not like this hallway.